a really good player with Samus. Like, we've been seeing a lot more Samus just like step up to the bat with a different meta game than what we were used to seeing online.
This matchup, though, it's kind of troublesome for Diddy, honestly.
Yeah, I feel like it's hard for me to sell it even, but I feel like the fact that like Diddy has the speed, a really good low profile, bananas, like any character that is able to low profile and have good speed against any of the Belmonts can give them trouble, just because like Belmonts can't handle that close quarters combat. They have to play you at a distance. And Diddy has tools to get in. Monkey Flip being one of them.
No, it seems... Nice catch. Yeah, it seems like whenever Tornado's got control of the stage with the projectiles, it's going to be very difficult for Kelly to set up. Like, as you can see, like, he tried to pull Banana, he got hit out of it before it's even active.
Yeah.
Right there too, like he tried to pull the Nana and he immediately has to shield because the cross is coming at him. If I'm a Tornado, I would get control of the banana and literally just use all the projectiles. It's like, what is D gonna do? Like, yeah. He can still hold his while he's doing the, he can still hold his item while doing all of his specials at the same time.
Yeah, but even though he doesn't have all the items, I think it's the fact that like he wants to go for like that 45 degree angle forward air, right? He wants to go for all those options because even though the items amount to a lot of damage, when it comes to kills, they only set up for plays. So for him to hold on to Ben, I feel it's like a really good play. But in the long run, it's ultimately he's going to need those forward airs.
Well, pretty close first stock. Playing really well. Nice. Okay. Wow, he's crazy. For the Pino gun snipe. Nice catch. Yeah, he followed where he drifted perfectly with that down here. Even though Color Star pretty good after him, he got the first knock, but unfortunately was able to deal any extra damage. Nearly even up the stocks there.
Yeah.
Watch out for the cross. Now I think Color is starting to get a hang of how Tornado is using his projectiles. He's having a much easier time getting in on this stock at least.
Mm-hmm. Good back air. Pulls for a little bit of a setup with the banana, but really good catch there on Tornado. Not gonna stop him. I do like the fact that he goes for cross when he's trying to come back on the stage, just so Diddy has to hold something like shield to try to fight back for each guard.
He also is pretty good using Juliana too. Normally, if someone's not experienced versus Diddy, then they just trip like all the time if they're not used to dealing with that. Wow, he actually, oh my god, that killed. That's crazy. He got to run almost full screen and grab Diddy Kong with Simon's like super slow run speed.
He needs to have the forward at him. Yeah, I think he went for like a full hop too, just to get that forward air, so that was really good stuff.
Yeah.
I felt like at that opportunity, Kuddler did not know where to DI, and the fact that like, that's probably not true, he probably was like, slowly it was worth killing Kuddler right now. Really good play with neutral air from the cross.
Oh man, get the pressure on the shield. Okay, Kuddler finds a way in there though. Control the banana as well, but there's the up DI shield super quick for Stoma. That might be their best up move out shield generally.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. That's not true. But Kuddler doesn't get a spark punish. Oh, okay, nice. Down throw into the monkey foot. It's a trip. Oh, but he didn't trip on the ground, so he wasn't even stunned enough to get the force match to connect.
Yeah, I like the fact the Tornado is just holding that down tilt as much as possible because he knows he can get a solid cross up and teammate from Diddy Kong to try to come back. That's a good snipe. From the
action. He actually positioned that perfectly. It was actually very little things he could have done to avoid that. Like, the only way he could avoid that, he would have to recover in a very awkward way to where he wouldn't sweet spot the ledge. That was actually really good. Snipe Tornado there. Still. Well, that was very quick. Are they just going to run it back on Smash Bros?
They might. I mean, we'll see. I was going to say, like, I feel like they might run it back, but I don't have to finish anything at all because they're not going to run it back. I would have loved to have seen a different stage change, but I mean, it's doing really, really good for both players.
I mean, sometimes I just feel like if you lose, it's good to just throw them for a loop with a different stage. But that was a very close match, so that's probably, you probably feel like it wasn't really the stage that was bad. He just wants to, you know, play better this game. Jeez, you only take 7%, all you have is more kill person pretty much. The ledge jump. It's nice recovery. I'm very impressed with, like, any Belmont player that's able to recover consistently. Stage recovery is not good.
Especially with the way that Tornado92 is doing it, where he goes for down air and he gets the right timing to go for an up B.
Nice stuff though for Kuddler to get that first silent taking 7% still. Oh my god. Actually, like, if you got that nugget flip and then read the jump and got like a dare, man, he was dead for sure.
Oh, that was
enough. Kuddler's going crazy. He's going insane on this stock right now. I'm just trying to get something started at the ledge, throw like all the holy waters, but it's not necessarily working out. Oh my god, what was that? What the heck was that?
Pinballed him around aerials, man.
I could have gotten the stock there though, if he was ready for the forward smash after he like messed up his recovery there.
Yeah, he also could have gotten an up B. I've sometimes seen T3 go for like an up B or an up air, so he's really good at pinballs.
Oh, barrels, dude. Oh, he's dead.
Yeah, and that downer, that was really good from Kuddler too. He kind of amounted for the fact that, like, he might go for downer to run on the stage, especially at the angle he's at, so I'm gonna have to do a little bit to punish.
And this is looking super good for Kuddler. Oh my god, he parried a Belmont 3-spot aerial. I mean, it's pretty much still impossible to punish, but it looks cool.
I mean, he's trying to make those plays, man. He really wants his W. Tornado92 though, bringing it up to 1-2 apiece. He's still at a stock deficit. I feel like he panicked. He panicked where he wanted to go for a directional air dodge to grab the edge. But that cost him and lack from it instead, and he got sent to the ground.
Yeah. He's also just in an awkward position. I mean, back to the stage. He probably just got scared to air dodge there, thinking that Kuddler would hit him with something.
Yeah. Chances are that would have been the case.
I guess so. This game really close. Second game though, pretty dominant win for Kuddler. So I'm pretty sure Tornado's gonna get the counter pick here, at least as far as stage go. I don't know. Yeah. I don't play. Simon or Richter, so I don't know what their really good stages are, honestly.
Same thing for me. Like, I wouldn't be able to tell you if smaller stages or bigger stages work for them, but I do know that in some cases, a smaller stage isn't necessarily a bad thing just because of your aerials, but it all depends on the matchup. And a bigger stage could be a bad thing depending on the matchup as well. Honestly, it's very, very dependent. Something that we've also noticed is, like, the Belmonts are characters we particularly see a lot in the meta. Like, we know they exist, but every time we get a Belmont, they seem to trade off to a different character. Like, for example, like Riddles. So, like, he used to main the character, you know, now he means Terry.
Mm-hmm. Still a few Belmont players. Like, T3 Dome and Frosty, the two. I know for sure we could just shoot that whenever he decides to play. It's Hockey Richter.
Alright. That went back.
You're gonna get a counter pick here though. Town. Oof. That was actually so good for Kuddler. Like, he's so. Like, it's so fortunate that he did like an air dash to catch the holy water. Because if he landed on the ground and caught his landing, he can die so early as sweet spot for a smash. He might have just died on that. I'm actually.
Yeah, but that was good for Kuddler too, to kind of slurk it. Like, really good opportunity for him to go for the up B. Just because even if he doesn't land it, it's still just for Kuddler to not be scared and take it away from it. I think that's the one thing I'm liking about Kuddler in this matchup, is he's doing a really good job of just announcing to where Tornado might be, and then punishing him for consistently, like, having to retreat to those set areas. Especially mm-hmm. when he goes for down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nice catch. Yeah, Tornado used a very lucky projectile there with the axe, thinking that, you know, he would catch a quick snipe, but Kuddler was right there where it needs to be. Oh! Okay, save his jump. But, damn, I thought Kuddler was going to go for the down air. He had all the opportunity to go for that. That would have been a really good stock for him.
Yeah, that was good for Tornado, though. I like the fact that he, like, even if he's off the stage, because he scared me by going off stage, but, like, he's making sure that Kuddler has to fight something like a cross or a projectile just to, like, buy him some time to come back, slowly come back.
Well, that's, like, the main way that they can recover. Ooh.
Yeah.
That's not true. It looks like it's true a lot of times, but at certain percents, like, you can just air dodge the up even.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry about it.
That was good. He came in with a no dodge, took out the banana, and took it out of his way. 161, though, Kuddler is still surviving at 3 stocks, and he wants this next game to be his.
Alright, Kuddler, man, his stock is just having way too much mileage for Tornado right now. Oh my god, another up B. At this point, like, he doesn't even really, I feel like he's not even trying to just kill him here. He's just trying to rack up all the 6%.
Yeah, but it's also good for him to, like, burst in on the stage, avoid up a lot of Tornado's options, because even if it's going to clank, it's a clank where he avoids getting hit by it and killed by it, and he's still going to have the barrels. So it's kind of like a 2-for-1. That's fine. No rebound.
He fought the drag down. Oh, he got the deep back here too. Yeah, he done the drag down there with, like, I'm a free grab, but
yeah, it would have been good for, like, a grab up throw up air or a grab down to forward air, especially for the ledge as well.
It's again, Kuddler finds himself with a decent percent and stock lead. Tornado forced to approach, which when you're as a kid like Belmont's, it's not usually a good thing.
No, not at all.
He's got really good approach options, honestly. Wait, oh my god, these dares are just hitting right now. Nice, catching him sleeping a little bit at the ledge, gets the free grab. Trying to set something up here at the ledge, nice, he's keeping him pinned, and dash attack killed? Okay, never seen that move killed in my life. We'll take it.
At the ledge, man, something's gotta go.
Okay, Tornado's screen is back. And so much pressure, oh, hits him out of the barrels? Oh no, but the monkey foot finds its way in there. And then now they're kind of coming in clutch. Oh man, now there comes Kuddler again. Run out all the random abs, man. Ooh, hold up. Yeah, I was getting these projectiles out right now. Oh, the clutch. Sure, he's living barely though. All right, nice recovery. Those are the platform. Oh, very risky down there. All right, this is very close. Both people can die. If anyone messes up right now. I was going for the up smash out of shield too.
Yeah, it was really greedy, but it was a good option too, especially if it was going to go for an aerial. Oh no. Regrab from the ledge! Regrab from the ledge!
Oh, you angled it down too to get the sweet spot. That was actually really nice.
Tornado calls out the regrab. He's like, hold on, he already grabbed it once. Alright. I can fix that.
That was a big comeback for Tornado. It's tough. This is best of 5 now, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And DSR is on or off?
Ooh, do we know? That I do not know.
Oh, let's see. That was super clutch comeback from Tornado. It's like, I don't know what happened. Like, every projectile just started hitting. It was like, Kuddler was avoiding everything at first, and then I don't know what happened on that last dog, and just, like, everything hit him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotta say, I'm not even super surprised. Oh, okay, he's getting destroyed, but he's not dying.
This man has not left the right side of the stage at all. He's been stuck there for like the past like 30 seconds of the game thus far. Yeah, dude, Tornado92, he is trying to make sure that Kuddler does not get stage space to even breathe. That's 110 already, man.
Yeah, Tornado, I don't know, he might have just gotten the second wind. Guys, momentum and ourselves from winning that with the clutch comeback. Oh my god, he's dead. We got like the... Oh, when Belmont's get like the angled down sweet spot on the back air. Cause that's so safe. And yeah. It's strong as hell.
It's strong, it's safe, it's got good distance. Covers up pretty good some options. Especially on the side.
And if they parry, it doesn't even matter because they can't even punish it.
Yeah, because you're so far away. Oh, Tornado had to go to the deep end because he felt that Kuddler wanted that badger so bad. And this is what I talked about from Kuddler. Look at him. He went for barrels just because he knows that even if I get clanked or if I get hit by it, I can still control the barrels and still get a pretty solid option there against Tornado.
Kuddler can't get set up. He can't get set up with his projectile right now. Every time he tries to pull banana, he gets hit by some B move from Tornado.
That's what we're seeing Tornado like constantly go for it too. Pressure on shield, pressure on the banana, pressure on the jump. Yeah, that's a lot.
Oh my. Alright, he just jumped into that one. he had not need to get hit by that B, but it's fine. He has Kuddler at kill percent. Kuddler's just struggling to get in on this guy. Look, he's trying to hit him with the barrels, and all he's doing is damaging himself.
Yeah.
No dice on that down throw, monkey flip. Oh my goodness, everything's hitting Kuddler. He's trying to retreat, goes to the ledge, hits him with the barrels, that's pretty good percent. Ice? Do the dash attack? Oh, now he will get the follow-up, it's rough for him.
Back
throw him off stage?
Yeah,
oh,
nice.
Kuddler instead. Really good opportunity. Yeah, he went for the DI mix. Yeah. It's fine because like he throws him off stage and then he has all this room to just throw everything out the way, as you can see. Okay, that's a good percent though with the barrels.
Oh, and
nice. Hey, hold up. He's really deep. Oh, and he got the snipe.
He's good.
He saved his air dive with the. Oh my god, that was such a good cover.
Yeah, he saved that jump at the very last second. Get back as a reaction from the side feet. Oh no, stuck in the jab animation. That's still good though. He's alive. 144. From across the stage.
That was good. Just barely kills.
That was good because he had been going there for that so long and he was able to charge him for feeling comfortable.
That Kuddler definitely brought himself back in this game. Oh, huge damage. Huge. He's really good.
Yeah, 100% on expert so far. Tornado at the ledge here.
Snail is struggling to get to center stage. Kuddler is all over this guy right now. Oh, okay. Nice. Catch the jump again. Good nice. Catch on the banana, though.
Yeah, good opportunity for him to toss it down, too. If he doesn't, like, hold shield, he will get tripped. Yeah, that was a good one. A tough call on the axe there, though. 110, nice good parry. Yeah, he has to go deep.
Oh man, he went so deep. No punish. Oh, he missed the tag? That's going to be big for Tornado, but there's the barrel.
I'm telling you.
Oh, smash out of shield will do it.
He knows Tornado loves to ride on him so much with down air, neutral air, empty land. He's been catching it like slowly but surely, and he finally caught onto it at the last second. That's why he's been going for up smash a couple times. Really good play, but also good stuff from Kuddler too, because I mentioned it, like that's some pretty much a broken record when I said it. He has been going for these burst in barrels because he knows the trades and the positivity of going for it, and that opportunity where he went for barrels, got Tornado 92 off stage, and then punish him when he was off stage for his landing. That's what got him the stock, and that was really good adaptation from Kuddler.
Yeah, that was just a huge comeback overall. Like that really looked like Tornado's game to win, like from the start, I think. But, I don't know, he just found a way to bring that back. Impressive. Wow. Five. This is I don't know who's gonna win this. They both have been playing so well.
Yeah, it's. This is probably one of the most exciting game fives I've seen in pretty hot movie.
It's two characters that we don't see that often, and I don't think we've been to this matchup in general before, really.
Yeah, we haven't. We really, really haven't.
The winner of this will play Burst, right, in the finals?
Yeah.
Yes, you use Inkling and Yoshi. Where are we going? Five. I'd love to see Kalos pick for Tornado, but it's probably banned at this point.
I would not blame him for it at all. All right, well, game five here. Last one to rock the set here.
Back on town. Both get to play on the stages they won on. Ready? Let's see. I can't even tell who's gonna win because, like, even when both players had, like, a super strong start on the other player, like, they still managed to lose somehow. This is gonna, I feel like it's gonna go down to, like, the last stock lap.
Yeah, and it's also, like, both players understanding of each other as well. They're doing a really excellent job of, like, understanding the calls, what they're falling for, what they're not falling for. I think the biggest adaptation I've seen so far is definitely coming from Kuddler, but Tornado92 is definitely not giving up on, like, going for different game plans. I mean, look at the cross there. Always coming back to kind of save the day here and give him the stock lead too from the first time.
Yeah.
Pretty big.
That was pretty clutch. This cross came back. It's like the boomerang. You have to pay attention when it's, like, coming back towards you. Good force smash there for Kuddler. Immediately evening things up. Oh, yeah, that drag down there is very inconsistent. It's not like it's guaranteed to get you a follow-up a lot of times.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, that down tilt timing, catch the banana. Good stuff for Tornado. Cool. Color's starting to get tired of these projectiles a little bit.
Yeah, I'm really good at him to go to the parry. It's not going to be anything for him to punish, but give him enough time to kind of come back on stage from the platform. I like that opportunity. Doesn't go for anything off the drag down, not even the grab. I think that's the one thing maybe 2992 might have to start like, understanding too, is how to punish Kuddler when he does bursting with barrels, because that's giving Kuddler a lot of opportunity, especially when he's so far off the stage.
Yeah, true. Oh, super snipe. That sucks too for Kuddler because he was on the platform, meaning that he was closer to the top blast than when he got hit by that. But dude, he doesn't care. He immediately just takes the stock back.
I mean, he knows
his game.
He was going to try to avoid the invincibility from the initial platform, and he went off stage just to try to fight that, and that's pretty much what cost him the stock there.
That was clean. That was clean. Crazy to think that like every gamer has been like going last to down the wire, but then on game five they're like the quickest game so far.
Yeah, they're pretty much going at it, man. Quick down smash.
Down smash, get him off the stage.
Good. That was.
Oh no, he's not letting him get back to center. Yeah.
That was a good lift punish. He kind of punished him really too for going for the first hit of down tilt. All right.
So you're trying to abuse this platform to just get like the craziest range on his holy water.
Yeah, because he knows how much he can get out of it too as well.
Alright, but Kuddler, kind of rough though, because Kuddler has a huge percent lead. It means Tornado is the one that has to make the plays happen right now.
That was good. He wanted to call Kuddler out, going for an aerial.
Why? Yeah, he doesn't want to get put in a ledge trap situation where he gets caught by the holy water.
Monkey flip is pretty hard for him to punish, but like, oh no, okay.
There we go.
Yeah, he was direction right down.
He's going up too.
Yeah.
Oh my god, that down tilt. Missing. Oh, that was a rough up B. I don't think he meant to do that. Oh, the barrels didn't get stopped by the holy water.
Yeah. See that? On the center platform. Yeah, it did not get stopped. I think it's because I got a little bit of the replay, but I didn't get to see it. There is situations where like the holy water won't stop you. It has to be the main flame of the holy water, not the initial like top flame of it. It's the center flame that'll stop you. So he basically barely got grazed.